Because nature gave children learning how to help plant and animals survive. In the first session, during age, the children search for small plastic animals you placed outside. Make some animals hard to see by setting them on a background that matches their color. Others should stand out and be easy to see. Make sure that all the animals are visible and none of them are behind or under anything.
If you see one, don't point to it. Don't grab it, okay? That can be hard for you. You've in your box. Hold them behind your back. So look very closely.
The children walk around and silently count how many animals they can find. Ideally, there should be some kind of border separating the children from the animals. During this activity, kids learn about camouflage, which is what something is hard to see because its color, shape, or pattern blends into the background. Animals that are hard to see are less likely to be eaten. During explore, the children count small paper moths and color those so they camouflage on their own clothing. Kids wear the moths and try to find them on each other. During session 2, children look at photos of animals, like this poisonous blue frog, and learn that bright colors can make animals easy to see, but can also warn other animals to stay away. Then they can make their own animals, either born colors or that are camouflaged. In session 3, the children learn that some animals are mimics. Mimics look like other things or other animals. Looking like a leaf, or like an animal that can sting, can keep an animal from being eaten. Children then create their own 3D mimics out of craft materials. As they work, ask their questions in session chat to help the children understand the mimicry.
So what do you mean?
It's like bug or snake.
How does mimicry help your mimics?
Just like other animals that aren't eaten, mm-hmm. Use the mimics to like a normal snake.
Make sure children understand these animals don't mimic a purpose. They weren't looking like they do. Color can help plants too. In session 4, children learn that colors can help plants attract animal pollinators. Animal pollinators move pollen from one flower to another, allowing the plant to make seeds for new plants. Children use the information on this poster to make flowers designed to attract a certain pollinator. For example, this seed flower is purple and has lots of little tubes to attract butterflies. Pollinators usually go to flowers for the nectar and end up pollinating at the same time. Pollination is how the flower makes seed for new plants. With seeds for new plants, even if that plant dies, that type of plant can survive. Colors of nature are meaningful, and kids have fun exploring them. Speaking of camouflage, did you ever notice this guy? You've been there the whole time.
Fun provided by Oracle, the Noise Foundation, the S.E. Bechtel Jr. Foundation, the David and Lucille Packer Foundation, and the Stephen Bechtel Fund.